Hi, my name is Christian, and here is my photography story. What I love about photography is the opportunity to capture my surroundings and preserve milestones. Also the process, taking in what is around me, shooting some photos, going through them on my computer, and editing. Through my photos, whether I post them on social media or print them out, I can share the experience with others and reflect back on memories. Normally, I like photographing landscapes, nature, streets, or my pets. Although recently, I went a slightly different direction. It started after I had COVID and took some photos of my surroundings while quarantining, since I couldn't really do much else. One of which was a sort of day in the life of being sick with COVID, holding my phone, scrolling through TikTok, and having cough drops and ibuprofen within arm's reach. What I was not expecting was the tattoo on my forearm to draw the attention of a few people, even though that wasn't the subject matter. From there, I went ahead and photographed my tattoos. Another interesting thing that happened was when talking to a classmate about my photos, bringing up landscapes and the tattoos and so on, he says something interesting. He goes, "Doesn't the human body also serve as a landscape?" And I realized he was right. A landscape is the visible features of an area and how they integrate with natural or man-made features. And tattoos are exactly that. My tattoos serve as a visible feature on my body. I also like referring to my body as my own natural canvas. I got my first tattoo when I was 20. I wanted something to represent that I'm a Gemini, but not solely the Gemini symbol. I added on traditional style eagle wings and the word bless to signify my gratitude for growing as a person. About a year later was when I got my next tattoo. However, my feelings on this one have changed over the years. Although I like the quote, I don't think I necessarily like it enough to have it tattooed on me. I'm probably going to end up covering it up one day, but have no plans as of now. I now look at this tattoo as an example of how growing older and changing as a human is that sometimes feelings change, which can be towards anything, tattoos included. It's what I wanted at the time, but now looking back, I don't think it was such a good idea to tattoo so many words in a rather confined space. One thing I came to realize is that I like getting tattoos that reflect on mental health. I got the diamond to represent inner beauty, strength, and invincibility. Another hurdle to overcome was accepting myself for who I am. Fitting in was always difficult, and I had a hard time accepting that I'm not as socially confident as others, or showing any strength or confidence, and developing anxiety, which to others stood out as weakness, and they would take that to their advantage. A diamond sits on the top of Mohs hardness scale, meaning they have excellent strength. Accepting who you are, regardless of your past, and how you want to move forward as a person, takes strength. And if you play your cards right, you can gain the confidence and feel invincible, like you have the strength of a diamond. Of course, diamonds are not actually indestructible, but I feel it only makes my point more realistic, that even the most confident of people can be broken down with whatever life obstacle comes their way. As someone who constantly struggles with anxiety, one of the things that it does is make you feel inferior to everyone else. I felt that way for a majority of my life. I would try to break that rut and remind myself that life is not a race, and what I'm doing is good enough, and that's all I need to care about. One day, I came across a mental health awareness fair run by my college's wellness center. One of the tables had temporary tattoos, which were designed by one of my peers. One of them said, "I am enough," and that's the one I picked. Afterwards, I kept looking at it. The phrase stuck out to me, and I decided I would get it in the same spot for real, much to the delight of the college's wellness center. About 3 years passed before I got another tattoo. It was long overdue, but this one was important. Juggling a full-time job, going to grad school, personal life stuff, so on and so forth, all while trying to make art regularly isn't easy. Finding the motivation to make the art was even harder. The word persevere means to continue in a course of action, even with little or no prospect of success. I know that I would rather try and fail in something than not try at all and wonder what could have been. So it made perfect sense to get this phrase tattooed on me. About a month and a half later, on my 26th birthday, I got the Friends tattoo on my arm. I don't really have much to say about this one other than that Friends is my favorite show. The sword piercing the skin was an idea that I had a while ago, but I kind of put it in the back of my head. Up until the middle of this year, when I lost my dog, a wave of depression overcame me. I was doing the best to cope with the loss and continue going about my everyday life, which included finding the motivation to make art and take photographs. At one point, I revisited the sword idea. I'm not saying you should get a tattoo as a solution when you sink into a depression. A tattoo you get should have meaning to you and should be well thought out. However, the sword was not a spur-of-the-moment decision, and it did have meaning to me. With that, I decided now was as good a time as any to get it. The sword represents power, authority, strength, and courage. All things I know I need to have in order to take control of my life. The woman with the flame silhouette was an original drawing by one of my favorite tattoo artists. She was also the one who did the I Persevere and the Friends tattoo. Going to her was the most comfortable I ever felt during a tattoo session. She is very personable and easy to talk to. Plus, the shop, compared to others I've been to, had the most welcoming environment, which made it even better. I found the woman in flame drawing elegant, and when talking with her more about it, I only felt more inclined to get it. That same day, we also did the arrow on my foot. Like I said, a lot of my tattoos reflect on mental health, and the arrow is no exception. The arrow represents struggle, triumph, and finding your way in life. Life can be confusing and tumultuous. I have been confused a lot about myself, including who I am as a person and what direction I want to go to have a fulfilling life. Even as an adult, these doubts still hover over me. I've never been much of a confident person and constantly remain undecided if certain choices I made would have worked out in my favor or I would ultimately be setting myself up for failure. But no matter how complicated life gets, I keep pressing on and taking it one day at a time. The arrow is what's pointing me in the right direction to live that fulfilling life I crave. The reason I chose to have it on my foot is because I'm almost always on my feet, for work especially, and also because I like going on hikes. Hiking on trails are where I do a lot of my thinking and self-reflection. Being out in nature is a lot more peaceful and makes it easier to think. Now that I have the arrow on my foot, I'm always walking in the direction that the arrow takes me. My most recent tattoo, which is still an ongoing process, is from my favorite movie, Spider-Man Into the Spider-Verse. In the movie, the main character Miles walks to the edge of a skyscraper and jumps. It's a very breathtaking scene, which stuck out to me. Miles was afraid, but still took that leap. And sometimes that's how life really works. You have to make a decision and go for it. Take that leap, no matter how afraid you may be. After photographing my own tattoos, I photographed a couple others with their tattoos and found it fun. Everybody has their own story with their tattoos, and it provides better insight on who they are. I found photographing tattoos to be enlightening, and I definitely plan on photographing more people with their tattoos in the near future. I suppose from here I'll see what direction life takes me. Just a matter of taking it one day at a time. As for the tattoos, I definitely plan on getting more in the future. For all I know, I may have to make a part two to this one day. As for photography and art, I definitely will keep pressing on and expressing my creative ability to the world. My name is Christian, and this was my story. Thanks for listening.